Well, good evening and welcome to our Trinity Church for our carol service here tonight. You are really welcome. We are going to begin with some prayers and then we will sing Single Faith City. The first verse is a solo. Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmas tide our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy John. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth, and goodwill among all people, for unity within the church which he came to build, and especially in this town of Formby in the diocese. And because this of all things will rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor, the helpless, the cold, the hungry, and oppressed, the sick, and them that mourn, the lonely and unloved, the aged and little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart for God. And lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us but upon another shore. Many a great fellowship, the multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are forever one. These praises and prayers let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself has taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And so may Almighty God bless us with his grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens of God, may the King of angels bring us all. Amen. So, we turn to number 539 in our hymnbooks, and don't forget that the first verse is a solo, so stand up for the second.
Thank you.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Great will be his authority, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do it.
Thank you. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered, "What sort of greeting this might be?" The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Thank you.
a blessing for after. This blessing is for the moment after clarity has come, after inspiration, after you have agreed to what seems impossible. This blessing is what follows after illumination departs and you realize there is no map for the path you have chosen, no one to serve as guide, nothing to do but gather up your gumption and set out. This blessing will go with you. It carries no answers, no charts, no plans. It carries no source of light within itself. But in its pocket, tucked a mirror that from time to time it will hold up to you to remind you of the radiance of pain when you gave your awful and wondrous yes. Thank you. St. Luke tells of the birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all work of God should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and he was expecting a child. While they were there, time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for him in the guest room.
Let us go now to Bethlehem
and see these things in a state of grace, which the Lord hath made known to us. So they went with haste, and found Mary, and Joseph, and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. And Mary treasured all these words, and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them.
So let's stand together to sing 503, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
For so it has been written by the prophets, and you, Bethlehem,
in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, but from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel. And Herod secretly called for the Magi and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen in the east, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to heaven, they left for their own country by another road.
Could find nothing better to do
see you today. It's lovely to see you all today. I do wonder, if there were any hesitations, any buts about coming tonight. So maybe you might have said, well, I'd like to go to the carol service today, but it's going to be cold and dark going home. Or maybe you were thinking, I'd like to go tonight, but you know, it's the last day of hosting tomorrow, and I've still got the cards to write. Or you might have said, I'd like to go tonight, but the foot is on. So well done, you made it. And I was reading a book by Sam Wells, who's the vicar of St Martin in the Fields in London, and he said that as we look at our nativity scene here, quite a few of the characters there had their own books, their own hesitations about it. Now if we go back to Zachariah, you remember Zachariah is the elderly priest whose turn it had come to serve in the temple. And so he went into the temple to serve, to do his job, and whilst he was there, he met an angel. The angel said to Zachariah, your wife Elizabeth will give you a child. And the child will grow up to be John the Baptist, and he will make way for the coming of the Messiah. And Zachariah looked at himself and he said, well, now, I'm too old. And then there's Joseph. Now Joseph there, betrothed young Mary, and it's all lovely until he finds out that she's expecting a child, and the child is his. So the angel explained to him that it's by the Holy Spirit that Mary's expecting this very special child. And Joseph probably just about gets his head around that. Then his mind is going, what will the men say? What will people think? Because they can all count. And then the innkeeper, well, the innkeeper's in our mind, is it? They just love to create the innkeeper, don't they? Said Mary had nowhere to lay her baby because the inn was full. So it was in the stable, she lays in the manger. So maybe the innkeeper's thought was that, but it's really busy. And then we heard about the magi, the wise men, the kings, all popular. They went where to the palace? They went to the palace in Jerusalem because they thought a king would be born in the palace. He wasn't. He went back to their books and worked their way to Bethlehem, following the star. Maybe their thought was, but this isn't the king we're expecting. This isn't what we expect. But then, of course, we have the other people who are more open to God working in their lives. And so, of course, Zachariah's wife, Elizabeth, what does she say? She said, but this is a blessing. God. And Mary didn't say, but I'm young, I'm scared, I'm a virgin. She said, let it be according to God's will. And of course, Jesus did get into the inn by the back door. And the shepherd, the kings, the wise men, they did find their way to Jesus. They went back to their doors and forth again. I've been thinking about the shepherds. I think of all the characters. The shepherds probably had the best reason to say what. They were considered quite lowly, really. They couldn't follow the laws of the Jews. They couldn't follow the laws of the pastors unclean. They were considered unworthy witnesses. And they had only sheep to look after. But when the angels appeared, they didn't say, but we're busy. But we've got the sheep to look after, but nobody will believe us. What did they say? Come, let's go. Let's go and see this thing that God is doing. So I wonder, thinking about the nativity scene, what our response is. What is our response? Are we, but I'm too old? But I'm too young? But I'm too busy? But this isn't the God I'm expecting, but I'm not clever enough, what is our response? How are we open to any new thing that God is doing among us now? And I've been reminded reading St. Paul's that, of course, Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us. And of course, God did find a way. Elizabeth was full of hope. Mary was faithful. The shepherds were keen. God found a way. I suggest to you that the good news of Christmas for us is that God invites us to be involved in what He's doing in the world now. And if we're prepared to commit to it, we will find a way. Amen.
Together to sing our final carol. It's number 588, C, and it's going to start.
Thank you.
service. God sent his angels from glory to bring shepherds the good news of Jesus' birth.
Amen. We thank you, Lord.
You have heard his story, the story of God's own Son.
Amen. We thank you, Lord.
So may he fill you with joy to bring this good news to others today.
Amen.
So may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.